Today's program, how to research the team of any given project.
Crypto Media Service, bringing you in-depth thoughts on cryptocurrencies.
Hello and welcome to Crypto Media Service. I'm the Golden Boy. I'll be your host today. Today we are going to be looking at how to research individual team members in any given project. We are going to take off to the BitGuild team. I will be researching one person from the BitGuild team, and the same process is to be repeated over and over again. And we will jump right over to the internet right after this. And we are here at the BitGuild team page. We are going to look at Jared Zagoda, since he's the CEO and the first one here. We cannot do anything with this picture, but we can see who he is. So let's go in here. We will come up with his LinkedIn profile. It should be said LinkedIn profiles can't be faked, so I will show you how to make sure it is the right person. First of all, let's look at this. We have, it's in Danish, I know, but experiences. CEO of BitGuild, founder of Livestar, CEO, co-founder of Reality Square Games. Reality Square Games is something big, so we should be able to find that as a reference point. And it's, back in time, and he has been there for 7 years and 9 months. It's a good reference point. Founder of Nobility Co. Ltd. He has studied at Ohio State University, Cheng Kong Graduate School of Business, and Yupan University. So, first of all, we will be looking at where he is now, BitGuild. And as we saw on the BitGuild team page, he's the CEO. So, these two things are coinciding really good together, so we will just copy his name, so I'm sure I'm spelling it correctly. And we will go over to Google. At Google, we can find everything about Jared Zagoda we want to find. So first of all, let's go straight into his Twitter profile. At his Twitter profile, I'm interested in looking at a couple of things. Is he staying current in blockchain technology, since it's a blockchain project he's a founder of? If it was a cryptocurrency project, I would like to know that he's current in blockchain technology and cryptocurrencies. And since this is a blockchain and gaming and cryptocurrency project, I'm most interested in the blockchain technology part and the gaming part, because the cryptocurrency part is not the main feature of this platform. It's just a means of exchange. So he is affiliated with BitGuild, that much we know. He is staying up to date on CoinDesk relating to China. He has been in Block Show as a panel member. That's a good thing. And we could go on that Ether Online. Well, it's a game, and it's game related, and it is Ether Online. It might be even Ether related, which is a good thing. And gamers and investors bet big on cryptocurrencies and blockchain, cryptocurrency and blockchain. So we have a couple of good reference points here to him being a part of BitGuild and informed, or somewhat giving information onward about the project he's involved in. And we have top 6 ICOs, which means he has been involved with the ICO, and because BitGuild is one of the top. But that's pretty far from number one to number two. Well, that's just it. Well, let's move on because his Twitter is affiliated with the things we like. Then we have something here, Forbes. This is a good reference point. It's an external source, which we like. We like external sources to confirm what he's saying. Forbes is a recognized source. We'll just continue into here. It is from 2014, where he was one of the 30 under 30, with the age of 27. And back in 14, he was at R2 Games. And I hate all those commercials coming up in the middle of my showcase. Well, but let's move on. There's Agoda, and it is just confirming R2 Games, Chinese games to Western players. But can we be sure this is a real Forbes site? This is not a fake site. It could be a fake site. Well, that's one way to check that out. Look at the address. If in doubt, remove everything past there, so you get to the front page. Once you're at the front page, what do you see? You see something related to Forbes. As a matter of fact, I know this is the real Forbes page, but sometimes you can't be cheated by a .com has been turned into a .co.uk. And it might seem totally legit. Another way of doing this is going back to Google and writing Forbes. Oh, Forbes. Mr. Keystroke there. Well, you will get what is Forbes, but you will also, usually as the first page, get their own page. And it is Forbes.com. You could try something similar with CNN. EditionCNN.com. There are a lot of sites out there pretending to be CNN.com. So always check up. But going back to Jared Sagoda, if this one want to work with me, there you go. What else? We have BitGuild interview on, where is that? Oh, Bad Crypto Podcast. And they have an interview with him. This might be interesting. I will not show you the interview. It's 33 minutes. But as you research, listen to what they have to say. I would have listened to such a podcast here. Because it is telling me something about Jared Sagoda. I will then continue the entire process throughout the team, starting with the top branch of the teams, the CEO, COO, CTO, VP, and it's all the VPs. And I would then move on this team. I would have gone through the entire team and I would continue down and taking the advisory board. As someone like Justin Soon, I know of him, but I would check Justin Soon, BitGuild, and to check out whether or not he is affiliated with BitGuild. And I would do that just by a bit, seeing if anything, Justin Soon on Twitter. I know it is his Twitter, this one. BitGuild Antron, and it is relating to another outside article, and he is confirming it himself. So that's how I research. You will then move on to go through the other resources, and that we will look at the next time. So see you there, and until then, have a great time.